in the midst of the church, he opened his mouth, and the Lord filled him with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. May Saint Dominic come to the help of your church by his merits and teaching, O Lord, and may he, who was an outstanding preacher of your truth, be a devoted intercessor on our behalf. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Habakkuk. Are you not from eternity, O Lord, my holy God, immortal? O Lord, you have marked him for judgment. O rock, you have readied him for punishment. Too pure are your eyes to look upon evil. With the sight of misery, you cannot endure. Why then do you gaze on the faithless in silence, while the wicked man devours one more just than himself? You have made man like the fish of the sea, like creeping things without a ruler. He brings them up with his hook. He hauls them away with his net. He gathers them in his seine, and so he rejoices and exults. Therefore, he sacrifices to his net and burns incense to his seine. For thanks to them, his portion is generous, and his repast scrumptious. Shall he then keep on banishing his sword to slay people without mercy? I will stand at my guard post and station myself upon the rampart and keep watch to see what he will say to me and what answer he will give to my complaint. Then the Lord answered me and said, write down a vision clearly upon the tablets so that one can read it readily, for the vision still has its time, presses on to fulfillment, and will not disappoint. If it delays, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not be too late. The rash man has no integrity, but the just man, because of his faith, shall live. The word of the Lord.
You forsake. sits enthroned forever. He has set up his throne for judgment. He judges the world with justice. He governs the peoples with equity. You forsake not those who seek you, O Lord. The Lord is a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of distress. They trust you in who cherish your name, for you forsake not those who seek you, O Lord. You forsake not those who seek you, O Lord. Sing praise to the Lord enthroned in Zion. Proclaim among the nations his deeds. For the avenger of blood has remembered. He has not forgotten the cry of the poor. You forsake not those who seek you, O Lord. Jesus Christ has destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. A man came up to Jesus, knelt down before him, and said, Lord, have pity on my son, who is a lunatic and suffers severely. Often he falls into fire and often into water. I brought him to your disciples, but they could not cure him. Jesus said in reply, O faithless and perverse generation, how long will I be with you? How long will I endure you? Bring the boy here to me. Jesus rebuked him, and the demon came out of him, and from that hour the boy was cured. Then the disciples approached Jesus in private and said, Why could we not drive it out? He said to them, Because of your little faith. Amen, I say to you, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, Move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. The Gospel of the Lord. Because of their little faith, they could not drive out the demon. So the question before us is, how do we increase our faith? There is an element where faith is a gift, and like any good gift, we must ask for it. It is by prayer that we increase our faith. We see this towards the end of the gospel, when Jesus is exhorting his disciples to keep watch, to stay awake and watch, to watch and pray with him in the garden. Because they fell asleep and did not pray, they were not prepared, and they ran away when the crucifixion came. But Christ himself, because he did stay awake and prayed, he was prepared. He had the faith to endure what was coming. May all of us be people who increase our faith by taking the time to pray, to be with the Lord often, so that when we are tempted, when we are tried in any way, we may be able to stand firm. the word of the Lord in our hearts and in our minds, we place our needs before God. For all the members of the Order of Preachers, the Dominicans, on this feast of St. Dominic, we pray to the Lord. For those who lead our communities, may the Lord give them the strength to govern wisely. We pray to the Lord. For those who have suffered illness from the pandemic, may the power of the Holy Spirit grant them comfort and healing. We pray to the Lord. For all those who are struggling with cancer or facing surgery, that they may find healing. We pray to the Lord. For we who worship and share here, may the Holy Spirit continue to enkindle in us the fire of his love. We pray to the Lord. For our own intentions, which we now call to mind, we pray to the Lord. And for all who have died, especially Ladina Pace and Larry Sattler, may Christ lead them to new life with the Father. We pray to the Lord. Almighty Father, in your mercy, hear and answer the prayers we offer today through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, who will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic, and through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthened by the protection of your grace, those who champion the faith, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Dominic you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Daniel our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May your church, O Lord, receive with wholehearted reverence the power of this heavenly sacrament by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of Saint Dominic. And may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be helped through his intercession, through Christ our Lord. is with sadness that I announce that our maintenance man, Larry Sadler, was killed yesterday in a bicycling accident. Please keep him and his family in your prayers. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Our Lady of Hope, Seat of Wisdom, Saint Aloysius, Saint Thomas More, Saint Dominic.